Friends, don't take the style of my preaching. Take the message, not the messenger. If a man come in that door just now, he might be dressed in rags. He might be or anything. But if he had a telegram for you that you had received $1 million, fell heir to it, you wouldn't notice the messenger. You'd notice the message. And my grammar's poor and different from your pastor. If the way the Lord deals with me is different from it is in your church, don't notice that. But notice what I said. Jesus Christ is raised from the dead. He's living among the churches today, bringing forth that same result, restoring back the faith that was once delivered to the saints. The same signs and wonders are proving and accompanying the ministry of this type. I feel led of the Holy Spirit to do this. I want to know, maybe you'll never meet it again this side of eternity. I don't know, I may never see you again this side of eternity. But from the depths of your heart, in the name of Jesus Christ, I ask it. If you really feel your need of God, why will your head bowed now and your eyes closed, let God and I look. Raise up your hand. Say, I really, Brother Branham, am convinced that I need more than what I've got. God bless you. There is a fountain filled with blood drawn from Emmanuel's veins when sinners plunge beneath the flood. Lose all their guilty stains. The dying thief rejoiced to see that fountain in his day. There may I, though vile as he, washed all my sins away. Ever since by faith I saw the stream, thy flowing wounds supplied, redeeming love has been my theme and shall be till I die. And in a nobler, sweeter song I'll sing thy power to save, when this poor lisping, stammering tongue lies silent in the grave. Some glorious day when you pass by my grave, some of you younger people, if Jesus tarry, I want you to remember that there lay poor old Brother Branham, but he sweated his life out for his convictions. He loved the Lord Jesus. I believe the man done his best.